Dear physics, will we ever be able to run from one cliff to another like we saw in the cartoons? Asking for a friend. Hey everybody, Trace here for DNews. Cartoon physics is the best. If I run fast enough, I can run off a cliff. I can strap a rocket to my back, I can slip on bananas. To be honest, we know that the first two won't actually work, and strapping a rocket to your back pretty much describes science from the 1950s. But the science of the venerable banana peel, that was elusive until now. The Ig Nobel Awards are given out every year to research that, quote, first makes people laugh and then makes them think. That's the kind of science I like. This year, the Ig Nobel Prize in Physics was given to peeps from Kitasato University in Japan for determining the exact coefficient of friction for the banana peel and what causes that slickness. According to their findings, the frictional coefficient of a banana on linoleum was about 0.07. And to put that in perspective, skin on metal is between 0.8 and 1.0. Lower numbers is more slick. So a banana is comparable to a lubricated surface. Non-stick Teflon, for example, is around 0.04. A wet road is still 0.2. That's positively rough. The researchers also determined by microscopic observation that the slippery nature of the banana peel comes from a polysaccharide follicular gel on the banana skin. But before you start commenting about why people are wasting their money studying this kind of sciencey stuff, how about some things that hit a little closer to home, right? I'm clumsy. I drop stuff. Why do you think we did this video on the 5-second rule? Science has finally found out why. When I drop my toast, it lands butter side down almost all the time. Using a toast analog to best model the behavior of bread and butter, students at Thiel College found that toast would land butter side down 63% of the time. Why? It's pretty complicated, but essentially the angular momentum of a piece of toast is related to the angle at which it leaves a surface, i.e. the hand or the table. When the toast tumbles, these angles determine whether the butter side is up or down. If you want to limit the butter side fails, make sure that the toast is more than 270 degrees or less than 90 when it begins its fall. Science has also explored the most polarizing food thing ever, cilantro. In 2012, a genetic survey was done on 30,000 people of European ancestry. They found genes that affect olfactory receptors in the nose. A gene called OR6A2 encodes a receptor that binds to a fat molecule fragment called an aldehyde. People with this binding get a strong emotional reaction to cilantro, probably due to an evolved connection between food smell and flavor. Some people really hate cilantro, and some people are okay with it, but they get a strong soapy flavor if they hate it. In a University of Toronto survey, people who have descendants from East Asia will hate cilantro the most, then Europe, then Africa. The least hate came from those of Middle Eastern descent, where, unsurprisingly, cilantro originated. What about you, though? Do you hate cilantro? Have you ever actually seen anyone slip on a banana? What food science do you want to know about next? You can share your meals and your thoughts down in the comments below. And while you're clicking around down there, this is Brian, everybody. Say hi, Brian.
Hi, Brian.
Brian writes Anywho, another show that I host with Katie Wayne and Tara sometimes on there. We got all sorts of people. We want you to watch Anywho because it's a great show. Brian, what are we going to show them?
We did an episode about animals attacking drunk people.
So the animals are responsible and yet somehow also the aggressors.
Yes.
The bobcat went into a bar in Cottonwood, Arizona and went crazy. It started chasing the patrons around the pool tables and eventually jumped on a man trying to take a picture of it. Finally, it latched onto a fleeing man's leg before the man hopped up on Coors Original, punched it in the face.
Watch it. It's really good. And if you like it, subscribe. And while you're at it, subscribe to DNews too.